The following review is intended for entertainment purposes and targeted for adult fans of the series.
Hello there, heroes. I'm the Orange Ranger, and welcome to Just the Facts on Power Rangers Dino Fury Episode 11, McScary Manor. Amelia's grandfather, Pop-Pop, heads to a spooky abandoned mansion to fix a pipe there. For some reason, but a spooky, ghostly voice sends him running. Meanwhile, at Buzz Blast, Javi and Amelia talk about story ideas they can do when a haggard Pop-Pop comes staggering in talking about the ghost encounter. He forbids Amelia from going to investigate, but when he accidentally leaves the mansion key sitting on her desk, she of course decides to go anyway. At the mansion, she finds not a ghost, but a Sporex beast, Tomtris. She calls the Rangers, but then the monster finds her and ties her up. The two of them fight, and Amelia just holds the monster off until the Rangers arrive. Javi gets blasted with a moon beam that enhances emotion. In this case, love or affection. But like, platonic love? It's complicated. The others fight the Sporex beast, Amelia getting zapped as well and having her anger amplified, until Mucus shows up and takes the monster away, saying this is not the mission she was sent to work on. Javi and Amelia go back to work, where Pop-Pop is working on the office AC. He asks Amelia for the keys to the mansion, and she admits to taking them and going against his wishes, saying that he's too overprotective of her and needs to treat her like an adult. Overprotected. He heads back to the mansion to find the keys, which she said that she lost somewhere, but it turns out that Javi had them all along. She decides to go to the mansion morphed as the Pink Ranger to give them back, seeing as if she just gave them back and said that Javi had them, apparently Pop-Pop would have realized that Javi is a Power Ranger, which really doesn't make any sense, but anyway. He thanks the Ranger for saving Amelia's life, and we learn that her parents disappeared when she was a baby under mysterious paranormal circumstances. And that is why Amelia is so obsessed with the paranormal, piecing together the mystery of her parents' disappearance. He swore to someone, maybe her as a baby, to always protect her. He gives her a red and orange dino key that he found in a crawl space in the house, the item that Tomtris was looking for, and she leaves when the monster attacks again, Void Knight having randomly decided to have the monster attack the Rangers instead of searching the house like it was before. The other Rangers all get zapped. Izzy gets really scared, Ollie gets really happy, and Zato gets really depressed, but unfortunately they call it super lazy, which is a missed opportunity at best, and perpetuating a negative stereotype about mental illness at worst.
You done f***ed it up!
On her own now, Amelia decides to use the new key, the Blazing Dino Key, which gives her full shoulder armor and the power of fire, which she uses to beat Tomtris back until she grows. Zato is too depressed to summon the Zord, so Amelia summons the T-Rex Champion Zord, but when she does, the Dimetro Blazing Zord pops out of the ground as well. By the power of plot convenience, the two are able to combine into the T-Rex Blazing Megazord and beat Tomtris with the power of fire. Back at Buzz Blast, besides a fairly decent comic wrap-up with Jane, and just Jane in this case, Amelia apologizes to her grandfather for flying off the handle and says she's glad that someone cares enough about her to try and protect her. Let's balance the scales. Episode 11, Oreo McFlurry. Pros: a very heartfelt core to the episode, Amelia and Pop-Pop's individual performances, and the amazingly orange Dimetrozord. Cons: the name takes away from the episode, the missed chance to call Zato depressed, and a lack of focus on Ollie Amelia. Gotta say it, just as good as I was told. McScary Manor gets 4.5 scales out of 5. People so often see Power Rangers as a show that's all flash and spectacle with no heart or emotion. Episodes like this prove otherwise. The interactions between Amelia and Pop Pop, both positive and negative, had real heart and made it believable that they are family. They're both kind of quirky characters, which makes them work very well as a family pair. And speaking of the two, they both turn in very strong individual performances. Pop Pop is always a delight, and his scenes alone in the mansion were very enjoyable. Amelia had some very strong scenes too, especially going one-on-one with the monster. I will say the scene in Buzz Blast where she was supposed to still be under the influence of the anger being increased was a little wonky. She was a little back and forth on whether she was or wasn't, but still overall very good. And yes, I would be remiss to not mention the gloriously orange Dimetro Zord. It is yet another case of frustration in that there is an orange Zord with no orange ranger to pilot it, but you know how in the Hamilton song Satisfied, Angelica says, "At least I keep his eyes in my life"?
At least I keep his eyes in my life.
At least Zords like this keep the orange in my Power Rangers. When I commented in a slightly eye-rolling fashion about the title of this episode while previewing it last time, I got a comment that basically said, "Hey, it's Power Rangers. Weird episode titles are par for the course." Granted, but this is an episode that features familial conflict, new backstory, deep emotion, and amazing girl power. Was McScary Manor really the best they could come up with? I came up with something better almost right away. Family Manners. Think about it. It's a pun. It references the family stuff in the story.
Genius!
I do not clutch my pearls about this as strongly as it's going to sound, but as someone who most assuredly deals with mental illness, it was just really disappointing to see Zato exhibiting known mental and physical symptoms of depression and be told that he was being super lazy. It doesn't even make sense. Laziness is not an emotion. And I know some people are going to argue with that because, yes, you can feel lazy, but that is a physical feeling, not an emotion, at least I think. What's more troubling to me is that so often people who are dealing with the symptoms of depression are told that they're just being lazy. I really just wish they had been bold enough to say that Zato was depressed. It's not like a permanent trait for the character, it's just the effects of a beam. And I'm getting to the point where the show is giving us a lot of hints about Amelia, but not enough substance. Amelia's real motivation in this episode was to prove Ollie wrong about ghosts. Isn't she trying to earn his respect? When she gets zapped by the monster, he immediately calls out to her. A concerned friend? Sure, but why is it always him? Seriously, think about this. If you go back and look, these two call out to each other in battle a lot. But how slowly is this going to be developed? At this point, I think we're ready for a story very similar to Dino Thunder, actually. The episode where Ethan and Cassidy accidentally got matched up on a blind date. Something like that where they can really have some fun with it. What struck me now that I've watched this episode is how it was a real middle-of-the-season filler. Yeah, there's a new Zord, but if you think about it, that happens kind of randomly. But it was really good filler. It advanced the characters with a nice, heartfelt, emotional story. It added some mystery to Amelia's backstory. Now I know where all those Void Knight and Mrs. Freeze theories have been coming from. And was just a fun episode to watch. Another sterling example of how good Dino Fury can be. So now we've reached another point of confusion. We have a preview released for the 12th episode of Dino Fury, which indicates that it's coming to Netflix, but it hasn't yet, and we don't know when it's going to. So with the chance that I'm going to have to eat these words sooner than later, for the moment, Kamen Rider Dragon Knight reviews are going to resume. So, let's take a peek at the third episode of Kamen Rider Dragon Knight, Kamen Rider Incisor. Kit fights Kamen Rider Incisor, a spoiled rich kid who has been fooled by a mysterious villain. When he struggles, Batman finally decides to train his new ally. That is going to do it for another Power Rangers Dino Fury episode review. Thank you, heroes, so much, as always, for watching. Now that the video's done, you can let me know what you thought of this episode, as well as my review of it, down in the comments below. And while you're down there, make sure you smack that thumbs up button to let me know that you enjoyed this video. And if you'd like to lend some financial support to my channel in a way that gets you some cool stuff, feel free to check out my Teespring store. Until next time, heroes, may the power protect you. She calls for the Rangers. Angelica says, at least I keep my... At this point, I think we're ready for... Wing Knight finally decides to train his new ally. Oh, no. I can't even call him Wing Knight. It's Batman. He doesn't even know that his name is Wing Knight.